everybody. Hi, Gethsemane. Welcome to 7 at 7. It is Wednesday night, and it is a beautiful night. I am out on the back patio, and when I first came out here to talk to you, there was no mower going on behind me, but you're going to hear a little bit of a noise of a mower in the neighbors behind us, but it's just so beautiful out tonight, and I hope you were able to enjoy some of this beautiful day, and if not tonight, a little bit longer before it gets dark. And so, you know, we have good news. At 7 o'clock every night, we have 7 minutes of good news, and so thankful for that good news. And you know, Sunday we are on this Relentless Grace in our messages at Gethsemane. And Sunday, Ron Yates preached a dynamic message, really. And I just keep learning more from it. I keep gaining more understanding and insight. And I just wanted to pull out a couple of things that he brought out. The scriptures he used were dynamic. Really, they were so great. And he used most of them, I think, are in the Amplified, and maybe one or two in the Amplified Classic. So I just want you to join in with me, take a moment, take a deep breath, and let's just encourage one another in this wonderful grace that God has given us. And so we learned out of Ephesians 1:3 that it says, let's celebrate God. He lavished every blessing heaven has upon us in Christ. He lavished every blessing heaven has upon us in Christ. So since you and I are in Christ Jesus now, born of the Spirit of God, we have something to celebrate. We can celebrate God and celebrate this wonderful gift of grace he's given us, because he says that he has lavished it upon us. So not only has he given it to us, but it is a lavish gift, and this gift is to be used. And then I love this in Ephesians 1:6, also out of the Mirror Bible. He says, his grace plan is to be celebrated. So we should be actually enjoying and celebrating this gift of grace that has been given to each and every one of us. And every one of us qualify, because we have been lavishly loved on by God. He values us. He values you to such a degree that he wants you to enjoy and celebrate this gift that he's given to you. It says he's greatly valued us and highly favored us in Christ. His love for his son is his love for us. His love for his son is the same love he has towards us. And you know, I guess I just, until Ron said that Sunday, I've never thought about it that way. I just hadn't. I knew God loves me because God is love, and he chose to save me, and I'm so grateful and thankful. But the same identical love that he loves Jesus, he loves you and he loves me. And then he was showing us about this in Ephesians 2:5. In this Mirror translation, Mirror Bible, I love this translation about. He says, this is how grace rescued us. So grace, the grace of God, has rescued you. For we were yet in that state of deadness and indifference in our deviations. We were co-quickened together with Christ. We had nothing to do with it. Grace freed us once and for all from the lies that we believed about ourselves under the performance-driven system, and now defines our authentic identity. I tell you, this is so powerful, this scripture here, how grace, first of all, has rescued us. So we have a lot to give thanks for, because the grace of God, the mercy of God, the love of God has literally rescued us. And when we were in a state of deadness and indifference, we were co-quickened together with Christ. And we didn't even have anything to do with it, but grace freed us. I like this. Once and for all from the lies that we believed about ourselves. Haven't there been times in your life, I know there have in mine, that I have believed lies about myself that were performance-driven, from this performance-driven system? But you know what? God says you've been delivered from that performance-driven system, and he has freed you from the lies that you believed yourself. And if tonight you've been listening to a lie, that little voice coming from the outside in, trying to tell you that you don't measure up, that you're not good enough, that there's something different about you, that God would not grace you or bless you, tonight you can go to this scripture out of Ephesians 2:5 in the Mirror Bible, and you can read that out loud to yourself and to that voice that is a lying voice telling you a lie, and no longer be controlled by it or controlled from it. Amen. Hi, Jan. Good to see you. Hi, Renika. Good to have you tonight. And so then I wanted to share with you that, you know how people say, sometimes they'll say, she's in a state of confusion, or he's in a state of depression, or they're in a state of shock. But if you remember here in this Ephesians 2:5, it says, while we were yet in the state of deadness and indifference, we were co-quickened together with Christ. And then in Romans 5, verse 2, out of the Amplified Classic, it says, through him we have our access, our entrance by faith into this grace. And in the Amplified, it explains this, the state of God's favor in which we firmly and safely stand. So here we are through Jesus. We have this access by our faith in him into this grace, which is a state of God's favor. So no longer are we to be in a state of confusion. No longer are we to be in a state of depression or a state of shock, because he has, through access in him with our faith in him, he has provided us this gift of grace. And in this gift of grace, we are now in the state of God's favor. And in that state of God's favor, he says, we firmly and safely stand. So you are no longer kicked to the side. You are no longer down and out. You no longer have to agree with that state of mind of fear or confusion. You don't have to agree with that anymore, because that's not you. You have been given this gift of grace, and now this gift of grace is God's favor to you and for you and working with you and through you, and it gives you a place to firmly and safely stand. You get to be firm and safe where you're at, because God has co-labored with you and he has co-raised you up to this place of favor. We don't deserve it. Some of us didn't even ask for it, and he just freely has given it to us. That just blows my mind. Sometimes I have a hard time comprehending it, but I keep reading it and I keep looking at it so that I can receive that favor and that grace. So we have found out that we did not obtain a lesser favor or a lesser love, but the same love. And that's because the love of God never, ever fails. The love of God, he is love, and his love has given you this gift, this wonderful gift of grace. And God tonight, just want to say this to you. If there's anyone here that's carrying any guilt, or you're carrying any shame, and it may be because someone caused something to happen to you, or somebody did something to you, or maybe you made some wrong choices and some wrong decisions, which, join the club, we've all done it. If that has happened to you in your life and you are feeling the guilt and the shame of it, God right now has mercy. He has mercy that he is giving to you, and he has applied his grace of favor and his pleasure for you. And that grace untethers you from the source of that guilt and shame. Right now, receive that. That grace untethers you from the source of that guilt and the source of that shame. So receive that tonight, this gift of God's abundant grace, and give thanks and celebrate this grace and this favor and pleasure that God gives to you and extends to you, and enjoy it. Just rejoice and enjoy it this week. Enjoy God's grace. Use God's grace. Rely on God's grace. Put your trust in God's grace, because he has freely given it to you, and he loves you so much. I want to say this too, if there's anybody dealing with cramps, cramping in your legs, cramping in your hands and in your feet in the last few days, I just thank God that His kindness is toward you. He sees it. He knows it. He knows some of you have even said, God, I have to have relief from this. He says, I've heard you. And He said, right now, I release you by my healing power from the cramping in your feet and the cramping in your legs, the cramping in your hands. The source of that dries up, no longer to torment you. God bless you. We thank God for you. And I'm so thankful you joined us tonight. Have a great week celebrating God's grace.